Well, that was over dramatic. Okay, fucking fine. I'll do the reference everyone was expecting. Just. I'm Connor, and this is a story. Have you ever thought about the Smash Bros. Characters? How their powers and abilities might gel together and mishmash into a super team of ultra powerful heroes? No? Just me? Okay. God, I need friends.
As with most things, there's a couple ways we can go about this. There's A, just doing the original 8, which is pretty boring. B, making our own super team, which is significantly more interesting. And C, just using another super team and putting Smash Bros. Characters into that spot. Obviously, B is the best and most creatively fulfilling option. So, we'll go with that. I'll still have the team consist of 8 characters, though, as a reference. A few ground rules. The team members have to be real and interesting characters, or at the very least, can be converted into a more interesting character. They have to be iconic, and they have to have a good team dynamic and with powers and abilities to work with and such. With every super team, we need a trinity. The Justice League as Superman, Batman, and Wonder Woman, the Avengers as Iron Man, Thor, and Captain America, and I'm sure there's plenty of others that I'm not so sure about. Either way, Nintendo's trinity of big hitters are obviously Mario, Zelda, and Pokemon. So for our trinity, I'm going for Mario, Link, and Samus?
Hold up, what? That doesn't make any sense!
Sorry, this is personal preference, but a bounty hunter is significantly more interesting to me when it comes to creating interesting interpersonal dynamics and stuff like that. But don't worry, the next character we have represents the Pokemon franchise really well. Red and his own team of Pokemon. Or any Pokemon trainer, really, Red's just the most iconic pick. Obviously, he'd have Pikachu and it'd act like Ash's, staying with him at all times and acting all cute and stuff. I mostly picked Red instead of Pikachu on his own because Red can at least be given some semblance of character past being cute, or whatever. It'd just be more interesting. His team of Pokemon could be anything, really. His team from Gen 2, a team representing some of the most popular Pokemon from a bunch of generations, etc. It doesn't really matter. Personally, this is the one I'd use. From here on out, we have a lot more freedom since we've already fleshed out the biggest hitters. For team member numbers 4 and 5, I've wanted to flesh out personality. 3 of our 4 characters so far are fairly serious, so fun characters like the supersonic racer, Captain Falcon! Why'd I do that? That was dumb. And the great ape, Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong is goofy, fun, yet a powerful powerhouse. Seriously, the dude was able to punch the moon down to the earth. I really don't know how this works, and I'm kinda scared. Captain Falcon is a dude bro with a cocky attitude and a buttload of skill when it comes to not only driving at hundreds of miles an hour, but also when it comes to fighting. Both of these two are powerhouses with a bunch of personality, and I'd argue they're very iconic. Next, I think Ness would be really great on the team, mostly because he'd have a psychic ability the rest of the team doesn't really have yet, and also because, depending on where you put him in life or on his adventure, it can make for some fun drama on the team. Think about it. With the idea on Earthbound of you constantly needing to contact your mother, it would make it super easy to make him upset about being away from home. And if we age him up a bit, he could even still crave adventure that is directly in conflict with him wanting love from home. Though I could see why someone would choose other characters like Robin, Mega Man, even Fox or Banjo-Kazooie. And finally, we have a series that's extraordinarily iconic and clearly not represented yet on the team. A series that's integral to Smash Brothers' history and its fame today. It's... Jigglypuff seen from above! Sonic! What, did you think I was gonna say Kirby? Okay, look, Kirby's cool and all, but he's so different from the rest of the team I've made here. It has practically no personality, and is so tonally different from the rest of the team. Now, Sonic, iconic, has interesting powers, and fits with the rest of the team. Now, that's what I'm looking for.
Thinking about the Smash Brothers Super Team is, admittedly, a little stupid and kind of geeky. But it's all in good fun, especially in the more casual side of the Smash community, who seems to be shunned at basically every corner.
Just do the fucking joke already, we all know you're gonna do it.
Really? Really? Okay. Fine, I just want some nice wrap up, but whatever, I guess. I can't leave this, like, circle stuff.